It's Yalla Home.
Yalla Home.
With Anna Schofield.
And Big Cass. We're live through till 8 o'clock tonight. It's 8 minutes past six. Thank you for joining us across the UAE tonight. All seven Emirates. We are live. And this is how live we are. We actually have a guest from Chicago, USA, of course. And the guest is my sister, Louise Rook. Actually, known to me as Louise Schofield. I just want to say that. But she's running with the new title of Louise Rook, family name, and has a brand new podcast out. Literally, it's about 2 months old. And it's called The Moving Overseas Podcast. And this comes from, she's an ex-radio presenter. It's important to say that. But has moved prolifically from one country to another for the last 15 years. So she's an experienced hand, and a few weeks ago interviewed Big Hass, and the episode was released yesterday.
I mean, really, without further ado, let's put our hands together for Louise Rook. Make some noise.
Yay.
Hello everybody.
Hello.
Hi Louise, how are you?
I am great. It is morning here. I know it's your evening.
Yeah.
Morning.
What time is it there in Chicago?
It is 9 a.m. Chicago time.
9 a.m.
Yeah, we are day for night practically. We only get to speak to each other last thing at night or first thing in the morning.
That's
so
incredible.
Weird,
well,
yeah.
First of all, the question is, how you doing? How's everything?
How you doing?
Yeah, I'm pretty good actually, because we are hitting spring in Chicago finally. It's a long winter here in the Midwest. It really is. And it's cold.
Right.
And there's a lot of snow. So it's nice that suddenly the sun's arrived and the temperatures are starting to climb. Hoorah.
Okay, so that's really funny. So it's snowing where you are virtually, and I've just spent the last 2 days on the beautiful UAE beaches here. I'm not bragging or anything, I'm just saying.
Yeah, but sure.
This is exactly it.
The sister thing is so cool, you guys. You gotta know, like, these guys, they're sister. This is so cool. If you can see what I'm seeing right now, they just connected to each other. Like, that's incredible. God bless both of you. Yeah, so go ahead, continue, Anna. So you're in the beach, she's in the snow.
Yeah, except that she left the beach. So this is all on her. Because, Louise, you used to live... You're the reason I'm here in the UAE. So 11 years ago, I moved here because I thought I want her life. And you were living here, literally, in the UAE. I came out to see you once, and I went home and said to my husband, we're going. Pack the bags, and we were there within a year.
That is true. And Anna actually talks about that story when I interview her. And that's coming out next Monday.
Oh, see, nice marketing right there.
No, she's good.
She's telling us, let's do a podcast, guys. Come on. What's wrong with you guys?
Promotion.
That's what I'm here for.
But that is true. That is a true story. You came and stayed, and you were bedazzled by the glittery, sparkly, UAE.
Yeah. Mm.
And you said, that's it. We're
that's
moving.
That's incredible.
Here.
I mean, let's talk the Moving Overseas podcast. First of all, congratulations, really. I salute you because I think podcasts are incredible. You taking that move and doing it and, making sure you edit. You are right now. We're watching you via the Zoom thing. I guess this is where you record from.
Studio, yeah.
Which is amazing. So tell us
it's a little wardrobe.
Yeah. Really?
It is. Yeah, I'm in a wardrobe.
You got to show me around. Flip the camera right now.
Okay.
No. Don't worry about it. Tell me about the Moving Overseas podcast. When did you decide to launch it and why?
Okay, well, I decided to launch it back in the summer last year. I actually lost my job. I was the managing director of a kind of big performing arts company.
What?
That was a non-profit, big organization in Chicago.
Yeah, she was the big cojone.
Yeah, and I'd been working there. It was kind of my whole Chicago experience, really, because we moved here 5 years ago and I started with them then. So it was a big shock. It was COVID related, of course.
Oh, man.
And then I thought, well, hang on a minute. Look, I've got a pivot here. I need to do something else. I miss my radio days. And I just thought, well, we've moved so many times. It was my husband that said, do you know what? You have so much to give in terms of helping people out who are doing the same thing that we did, those moves overseas. You should start a podcast.
Shout out to, what's his name? Shout out to him.
Lee.
Shout out Lee, man. I see you, my brother. Yeah. This is just incredible.
He the man. So he kind of was the one that suggested
it.
I'm just having a blast right here. It's just true, unreal. Like, they have the same vibe, like, in a way. Like, that's crazy. Okay. Yeah, so go ahead.
Yeah. Yeah. Anna's posher than me. But anyway.
Fact.
That was the idea. And so, Anna, obviously, I love talking. I'm familiar with the mic, and had all of this. I was brimming over with wanting to talk about moving overseas with your family and everything that goes into it. And so that's how the podcast was born. The other reason was that when we were making these moves, I didn't have anywhere to go to. Like the first time we moved to the UAE, that was our first move from the UK. I had no clue what we were doing.
No.
And we made tons of mistakes. I mean, I talk about this in the earlier podcast.
Wow.
You know, we made loads of mistakes because we didn't know what we were doing. Had there been something like this, a podcast that I could, you know, tune into and pick up some tips and I don't know, just somebody who I could relate to who'd been through the same thing, it would have been like gold. And so that's what my intention is.
And it's been, it's been amazing. I know that you had 750 subscribers before you even launched your first episode, didn't you?
Yeah, I've got a lot of friends.
God bless.
And there it is, the end, people.
No, that's amazing, really.
Yeah, she did. She hadn't even launched the first episode, which for some reason on podcasts, they call it episode zero. What's that about, Lee?
Yeah, I love that. No, that's a thing.
That's a thing.
Yeah.
It's kind of like the what, the why and the who and the setup of what is this podcast going to be about. That's
right.
Episode zero.
I wanted to see if we can play. Obviously, I wanted to play the intro. I like the intro.
He likes the intro, Louise.
Yeah.
I like my intro.
Somebody's voiceover is in the intro.
Yeah, I've got this professional voiceover artist. I believe that she's the global voice of Emirates.
Yeah, was she? Like, is she cool in person? Is she nice? Like,
She's really cool, yeah.
And how did you make that happen? Cool. Like, you know, someone like that is very hard to reach.
I bribed her.
Yeah. Payment. It works every time.
No,
Hardcore cash.
We're talking about Anna Scofield. I'm playing this from my phone. I don't know how that will sound like, but we'll see. Can you guys hear?
I can hear.
Yes.
Yeah, it's good.
To the Moving Overseas Podcast, Family Edition, with your host, Louise Rook.
Who did the music, I want to ask? Because that's super. You got it from... like online or something?
Yeah,
I got it online from one of the places that you don't get into trouble for using
copyrighted. Amazing.
So I just want to say that right now.
No, but yeah. No, but I really want to salute you. It's been I've actually listened to the what and who episode. You know, I've actually heard that because I wanted to get to know when you first told me that. You know, Louise was getting me on. I was really honored. I wanted to know what it is all about. And it's just incredible. You, Louise, you say that you've made three moves in the past 12 years?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
So we moved UK to UAE, then from UAE to Canada.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that was a huge weather extreme. I mean, I cannot even tell you.
UAE to Canada.
Yeah,
wow.
The desert.
Flesh-eating days.
The snow.
Yeah.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, face freezing days. Yeah, that was you know what they told us at the school when we first took the kids along to their new school. They said, "Oh well, we let them play outside unless it's a face freezing day." And I said, "What's a face freezing day?"
Yeah.
And they said anything below -20.
Yes,
and that's
Celsius.
How people live. They just live in those extremes. And that's probably what we should talk about when we bring you back next. I think we should talk about those extremes because you did. You dived from the desert to the snow, and then you moved again, and you went from Canada to the Windy City of Chicago. I know that you're planning another move soon. So we'll talk about all
Maybe.
Those things. Maybe.
It's Yalla Home.
Yalla Home.
With Anna Scofield.
And Big Cass.
20 past six, driving you home across the Emirates tonight. And we're live through till 8 o'clock. Of course, it's Tuesday. It's hump day here, which means downward slope towards the weekend after today. And we're joined in the studio via Zoom because of the pandemic by my sister, Louise Rook, obviously formerly Louise Scofield. I just want to say that. Louise Rook, who has a brand new podcast out, the Moving Overseas podcast. And it literally, just so that you know, is for people who may want to move abroad but don't know how. What do I do? What are the first steps I need to take? Is it even feasible? Is it possible? Will I like it? Will I not like it? Will my family be okay? Can I see them? Can I take the cat? Can I take the dog? Will my children get the right schools? All of these questions, they're all part of this podcast, the Moving Overseas podcast. And Louise also, amongst having her own many international moves, she's a prolific gypsy. She just loves to move. I am, but she's worse. I just do it internal. She does it globally. But I think what she's doing is creating these lists of do's, don'ts, watch out fors. And it's facts. For the whole globe. So gradually, at the moment, it's the UAE, but she will also move through lots of different countries.
Loving it. Louise, so let's talk about maybe, obviously, you move from England to the UAE.
Yeah.
And then the UAE to Canada, and then Canada to the United States of America.
Yes, correct.
Couple of questions here for you. Which one was your favorite move? Not more difficult or not easier. The one that you're really, really happy about. Is it the current one right now? Or is it the first one? Or tell us.
Oh,
tough question.
You know, they've all been so exciting for different reasons. I think I was probably the most excited to move to Canada, actually.
Wow.
I'm
not sure if I can tell you why.
Tell me.
I don't know. I think it was because I'd heard so much about Canada. I think it was because we'd never skied before, and that opportunity was very exciting.
Wow.
And that we were going to be living, you know, we lived in Calgary, which is a 45-minute drive from the Rockies, you know, from Banff.
Yeah.
And we were so lucky to have that on our doorsteps. I think we'd been living in the desert for 5 years, and that was fantastic, don't get me wrong. But the thought of something so completely different was genuinely exciting, very exciting.
Would you say that you move, Lou, to something different because it's that sheer joy of change?
That so was a definite really yes.
Is. Yeah, I think that she's like, adrenaline junkie in terms of what's the most bizarre place we can go to next. Like, you know,
not quite, but you're right. It is like I start to get itchy feet.
Yeah.
And I start to imagine, like, oh, I wonder what it's like to live there.
Yeah.
Or I wonder what that city's like.
Yeah.
And yeah,
But you know what I hear? I hear courage as well, and I hear exploration, and I hear just diversity of culture. Because right now,
adventure.
You know, you've been in the UAE, obviously, an Arab country, and you're Canada, US. It's just
it's the rainforest next, isn't it, Louise? You're going over to swing from the trees, live in a log house.
It would be, that would be funny. It would be something like along the lines of this.
Here we go. Oh. He loves to play this, Louise.
Louise coming in.
Arriving with
Hello,
a podcast.
My people.
Yeah. Welcome we are moving to Africa.
We are moving today.
So, but I mean, on a serious note, the Moving Overseas podcast, plural. The series at the moment, which is obviously special to my heart, special to Big Hass's heart, is all about your move to the UAE, but not just your move. That's not what you've done. Actually, I know that for the last couple of months, you've been interviewing people who have moved to the UAE from all over, haven't you?
Yeah, and that's exactly what each series focusing on different countries will be.
Right.
A series of interviews with people, with folks from all over the world who have moved with their families to that specific place. And so I've been interviewing people who have moved to the UAE from Bulgaria, from the States, from Saudi.
Yeah.
You know, people who have had all these different experiences and then asking them to share what their challenges were, what their two best pieces of advice would be for people who are doing it. You know, we talk about everything. What do you love about living there? What do you hate about living there? You know, we really get into it. And when I interviewed Big Hass, he was fantastic because we were laughing about this earlier because he even says during the interview, oh man, I'm just letting it all out here.
That
Look,
is so you,
I mean,
Hass.
I'm talking to somebody who had radio experience, which was actually my next question. How different do you think this podcasting thing is from radio? Because obviously right now, we are on radio. Yeah. You do your podcast. What is the main difference, if there's anything? Because I personally believe with podcasts, you're more free. Like, you could talk about anything. There's no censorship in any way, shape, or form.
Yeah.
But what's the difference, and how was the experience so far? And again, more power to you, Louise, because I think you taking that step and launching it out to the world is like a, you know, salute.
Oh, thank you. It was mildly terrifying, I have to say. What I love about the podcast is that it's not live. So that I quite like because it makes me feel safe and secure.
Right.
Because sometimes, you know, when things are live, Anna and I have got ourselves into all sorts of trouble before, haven't we?
She told me a couple of stories.
Yeah. When you accidentally say something, because you get very comfortable, you know, with your co-host, or, you know, you get very comfortable on air, and then you sort of forget that there are things that you can't say. So what I love about the podcast is that I can edit it afterwards, and so I can completely relax when I'm recording it, and it's just me, you know, and I don't have any stress or time pressures is the other thing.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
you guys are working towards the news or an ad break or, you know, the podcast is very freeing in that way. I can decide exactly what goes in the middle of the podcast. I can decide on everything. So it's completely mine and it's not live. And it's, you know, so those are probably the
power hungry she is. Power.
Yeah. I want you to be honest with me. How much difficulty was it to edit my podcast?
Oh, I can imagine.
They all take me quite a lot of time, I have to be honest. I tell you what I've noticed is that everybody does this and I do it, and I drive myself crazy, is that I say a lot. And also people repeat themselves. So they say, they say, they say. And so because I want it to flow.
Did Hass do that? I bet he
I think I did.
Big Hass, you were number one for that.
I like,
but I noticed that I do it all the time.
It's
really annoying because it takes ages to edit, because you don't really want, when you're listening to that, you don't want people to keep repeating themselves. What? So I try to edit it.
Before we go to a quick break, what was it, like, what was, like, technically, how was it for you when you wanted to start? Like, did you get into, like, this whole, I want to research getting a mic? Because just for people who are listening right now and want to get into podcasting, how tiring, easy, difficult, hard, you know, was this whole thing?
Actually, it's not that hard. I think the thought of doing it is the biggest thing. You've got to get over the hurdle of talking about it and coming up with the ideas and then actually doing it.
Right.
I bought myself a mic. I did a ton of research. That was one thing. And I actually, that's one thing that comes up in the podcast all the time, is do your research when you're moving. But just for setting up a podcast, there are loads of people who have done it and that have done podcasts about how to start podcasts. And they are worth listening to, because I picked up some really great tips and advice for doing it. But I just bought myself a mic. I eggshelled the wardrobe. Got myself some headphones, and then I just started playing around and recording.
I mean, our boss would be very impressed with that.
He would. He'd absolutely love it. Mr. Yanis, we were all about that during the pandemic, because we obviously had to do our shows live from home.
Now,
you mentioned it earlier, the difference between radio and podcast is that we now need to go to the headlines, which we're going to do now. But when we come back, I think it's really important that we talk about Big Hass's interview, because through all the joking, I know that actually it was quite a profound moment. He was able to share with you things that he's never shared with anyone on any interview. And this is Mr.
Exclusive
Media here.
Exclusive right here for
Louise. This is Mr. Media, and he talks about Ahmed, and you talk about, you know, how important it was for you to find somewhere that understood autism properly, and that meant everything to you and Hanan. And so through all the jokes, we need to talk about that.
Amazing. Louise Rook, you know, stick around. We're going to be right back.
Yellow Home with Ella Scofield.
Oh, Hass, you're pulling it out of the bag playing this music. This is, you know, take that and all that. 20 to 7, we are live through till 8 o'clock. It's Yellow Home, of course. Driving you home across all seven Emirates tonight. And very, very special, because my sister, Louise Rook, there's no kind of easy way to introduce this other than just to get kind of excited to go, my sister's here. It's Louise Rook. She's launched. Woo! He's nuts. She has the Moving Overseas podcast. If you are thinking of moving anywhere else, this is the podcast to listen to. But also, not just that, if you're interested in other people who have moved about and what they're doing, you can listen to it too. It's a series of interviews of people who have taken giant leaps across the globe, Louise being one of them. She's on her fourth or fifth. But we've talked about lots of different things, Louise, with this Moving Overseas podcast. One thing that I really want you to chat about is the interview you did with Big Hass. Now, he is obviously a lovely big noise that we all know and love, okay? But actually getting him when he talks properly and about his family, and it's quite emotional.
When
you know,
he talks
he's
properly,
a powerhouse.
You can tell when he talks properly.
When he talks properly.
It's one of those days, you know
no,
what
but,
I mean?
No, but when you're not going, yo, 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 fam. You know, when he actually is like, I believe in this. You know, it's lovely and it's incredible to be around. And I know this. So when I hooked you up, I knew it was going to be amazing. Tell us about the interview you had with him.
Oh, I loved the interview with Hass. It's got to be one of my favourites so far. Because what I loved... yes, of course. And there was one with my sister, and that was really good as well. No, but you were brutally honest. And that's what I love. Because, you know, there are challenges. Even if you love the place that you are moving to and that you are living in, there are always challenges. And there are always things that aren't quite as great as you'd like them to be.
Yeah.
And that was what was great about you, Hass, was that you were like, yeah, I'm letting it out. I'm just going to tell you how it is.
Yeah, but Louise, to be honest, it takes also a good person. You know, I felt really, you know, I never had the pleasure of meeting you, but I felt like at home. You know, it was really
nice.
No, yeah, seriously, it was really cool. Yeah, I know you're obviously a sister of Anna, who I love and respect. 3 years now down the line, we're working together, but I'm talking about you specifically. It was a good conversation. It was a really good.
Great conversation.
And I don't have that conversations like, because most of the conversations I have are about hip hop, about independent artists, music, and no one really asked me why you move and about autism, for example, and stuff like that. And we delved into that.
Let's talk about that.
Well, we talked about everything. I mean, because I wanted to know why, you know, what had prompted your move. And that's how we started talking about your son and you know, how there were more opportunities for him in the UAE. And we talked about that. And we talked about the cost of living, which is obviously, you know, it's a big deal for people who are moving over, particularly for families who are moving over and their employer is not taking care of their rent, for example, or their school fees.
Yeah.
Because it's expensive. Yeah. And so we talked about that. And
the mistakes we've done in moving and stuff like that.
Did you make some mistakes?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Saudi to the UAE. That was your move, wasn't it?
But you got
to
tune in to the podcast, which is available at familiesmovingoverseas.com/podcast. That's where you find it. And it's on Spotify. Louise, a quick question. I noticed on your podcast poster, it says here the Moving Overseas Podcast Family Edition. Do you have any other, do you have any other editions, or is that it? Like, tell me more about that.
I've got everything planned. I've got so much planned. So this is the Moving Overseas Podcast Family Edition, and it is all about families moving overseas, because I think that's a very unique situation, moving over with your family. It's very different to if you're moving overseas as a single person or as a couple. It's a totally different ball game when you're moving with kids, because there's so many other things to factor in. And I think that later, you know, there's going to be the next series, we're focusing on a move to the USA.
Right.
Probably the series after that, we're going to be talking about moving to Australia and different cities within Australia, within the US.
Wow.
And also the website is going to become a fountain of information, because alongside the podcast, you're going to be able to jump onto the website and go, okay, I'm moving to Brisbane, for example, in Australia. I want to know, where are the best areas to live?
What
are the best schools?
That's
I'm going to have all of this information.
It's like the yellow pages of moving.
It's going to be the go-to for people moving overseas. So yes, Family Edition is right now, but I see in the future maybe we'll do Student Edition, maybe we'll do
are you guys like this
edition
in the family, like that? Like, all well planned, because this shows vision.
Yeah.
This shows a Family Edition. She has, like, she's saying Student Edition, other editions. It's going to be like, that's incredible. I mean, you know, if I had the money, I would invest in this podcast right now, because it's going to be crazy afterwards, you know?
She's got some sniffers. There are there's people sniffing around. She's got a couple of
it's
large companies. Well, I called it sniffers. I've got a personal question for you, Louise. So she's gone.
How personal?
Hysterics. Yeah.
This is where this whole thing gets. I'm from Saudi Arabia. You know, these guys are from England, and it goes like,
are we going too far?
No. Sorry.
Always. And then the thing with so that everyone knows off air, it's really funny, because obviously you've got two English girls together, and so it was really fun messing with Hass, who obviously is from Saudi Arabia. So super cool. But when you get two English girls together, he was like,
got no idea, fam. You know, I just don't show it all the time. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
He's just super cool.
He is. super cool. Let's talk about you and your favourite move, Louise, very quickly, because obviously this has come out of passion, this podcast. You didn't just sort of wake up and your husband said, do a podcast about this, and you're all right. You know, I feel like there was a bit more to it, because it is something that you've done quite a lot of, and now you're able to talk about all these things. So we talked about what your favourite move was. What's been your favourite place to live? Mm. Bearing in mind that you lived in a UAE. How long were you here? 7 years in the UAE?
Okay, so no, we were actually in the UAE for 4.5 years.
Okay.
We moved to Calgary in Canada for 2 years. Now, we would have stayed. However, my husband lost his job. At that time in Calgary, it was impossible to find, because obviously when you're on a visa, he needed to find a job with a British company.
Yeah.
So it's not as easy as just, you know, finding another job. So we had to leave, and the job came up in Chicago, and that was terribly exciting because I think we'd always fancied a move to the US.
Well, what does your husband do, if you don't mind me asking?
He works in recruitment, actually.
Let's go. I mean, in Chicago, we're coming. In tech. Oh, tech. Oh, no.
Tech. Yeah, you're out, Hass. You're out.
That's so cool. That's so cool.
So that's why I've said in earlier podcasts, actually, that, you know, we're not the typical expat family. We haven't been moved around by an employer. Yes, some of the moves have been helped by an employer. You know, there might have been an allowance given, and some of it has been facilitated by them. But ultimately, we've kind of organized it, and we've looked for jobs in the areas that we've quite fancied going to.
Yeah.
So I don't know where to say would be my favourite place.
UAE.
I maybe.
Oh, maybe.
She gave it to you.
Yes, she did.
That's like real.
I have to say, the UAE for the sunshine, I miss that more than anything. I love that. And it's interesting because that comes up on the podcast all the time by every single person I interview.
Yeah.
What do you love about living in the UAE? The first thing they will always say, I love waking up to the sunshine every day.
Magical.
Okay, a bit of a serious question right here. We're really enjoying, you know, our time with you. I hope you are too, Louise.
I love it.
So my question is, you interview a lot of people. I've seen that you interview people like, you know, I'm from Saudi Arabia, you interview the Lebanese lady, and there's other couple of people. Does that also, are you getting informed about other cultures of the world through this podcast in a way or another?
Yes, because actually they have different experiences, you know. So actually the Lebanese lady that I interviewed, Leila Shagari, she was really interesting. She told me something that I didn't know. When she moved to the UAE, she had to take a driving test, even though she had her Lebanese driver's license.
Yeah.
Now, as a Brit moving to the UAE, I didn't need to take a test. They saw my British license and that was good enough.
Yeah.
But she was very honest and said, yes, but in Lebanon, we sort of do our own thing on the roads.
Nicely said, right there. I was trying to find a way. What you gonna say?
They drive how they like, and so and she said there's not really any rules. So I think, and she said the UAE are aware of that, and so they make us take a test.
That is crazy for a Brit to hear.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm telling you. I mean, even in Lebanon and maybe other countries as well. Like, if you're going against the road and the car is like, you know, like guy
coming head to head.
The person who is making that follow is like, hey, what's wrong with you? I'm going through. I'm like, hey, you're in the wrong direction.
Right.
They're like, yeah, I'm passing through. Like, yeah.
Well, so it's like a standoff. Everyone just keeps playing chicken.
It's a vibe. But I mean, that was really honest from her. So the answer is yes. Like, you get to know other cultures somehow, some way through this podcast.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, everyone's had a different experience. You know, the lady that I spoke to, who was Bulgarian, and but she was married to an American, and they'd moved from Wisconsin.
Mm. Wow.
They had a totally different experience because they were coming from the States, but she hadn't actually got her US citizenship yet.
Oh, wow.
So they had a whole different thing going on. You know, there's all these different situations, and it's about kind of helping people to recognize some of the things that they need to do and to be aware of before they arrive and before they go. There's so much to do before you leave.
And I think we love that. That's incredible. We're going to take one last short break, and then we're going to be right back with Louise Rook. Definitely go subscribe to the podcast, familiesmovingoverseas.com. That's the website, and then /podcast. You'll be able to find all the podcasts. And please do yourself a favor, do your eardrums a favor. I think it's really remarkable. before.
Yellow Home
with Ella Schofield
and Big House.
It helps if the mics are up, Hass. Hass is so busy scratching and messing with Louise on Zoom. Look, forgot to bring the mics up.
I'm enjoying
8 minutes to 7.
Yes.
And we've got my sister Louise Rook, formerly Louise Schofield, to say the Moving Overseas podcast, which was launched a few weeks ago, and it's all about everything. If you're just joining us, everything about moving overseas globally. Now, if you go to the website now, there's a website as well, familiesmovingoverseas.com. If you do a bit of slash podcast on there as well, you will find every single episode. Yesterday's episode was dropped. Look at me hanging loose with the kids, and it's an interview with Big Hass. And then I think there's one more to go in the series, Louise, isn't there?
Yes, and no, there's two actually.
Woo.
So I've got you. Your episode is going to drop next Monday, and that is a great interview. We had fun, didn't we, doing that one?
We really did, because actually, I can't remember the last time we were kind of on air or in a recording situation together, and it was probably here in the UAE, because we both worked in other radio stations here in the UAE, and there was a couple of times we were on air together, and it was good fun.
100%.
What are you doing? You're faffing with stuff, aren't you?
Yeah, Louise, I just wanted actually to play a little bit from the podcast, if you don't mind me. This is me, I think, talking about diversity, right? Check it out.
I just love the diversity in it. It is definitely the diversity. I love the fact that you would see, you know, from an Indian to a Filipino to someone from Australia, someone from the UK, someone from the United States, someone from Syria, someone from Egypt, which proves the fact that we could all live together.
And I love these things. Obviously, Louise, we are approaching the end of our interview. But I wanna ask you how challenging maybe was it for you to also, when you do a podcast like that, you have to also put it out to the world on social media. You're still building a following. You're still building a little bit of attraction. So for you, when you cut these pieces, what do you focus on in terms of, like, why did you pick, for example, that part? Why did you pick the autism part? How do you pick the best parts? Is there a strategy or how do you go on about that?
I'd love to say that yes, there is a strategy and I've got it all planned. No, I think I just
that's my sister.
Pull out pieces. I'm a fly by the seat of my pants.
Yeah, she is.
No, but I pull out pieces that I think would pique people's interest. And also what, for you in particular, we talked a lot about your son, and also there's lots of parents with autistic children.
Yeah.
And so it was great to highlight that, because you were talking about how that impacts you in the UAE and how much help there is in the UAE. And so that was good to highlight that, because there'll be lots of people that would be very interested in that.
I want to thank you for giving me the platform to talk about that.
It was great to I wanted to talk about that. And so I try to pull pieces that I think that will be relatable for other people, in particular, pieces of advice. Also, you talking about diversity. I mean, what is the biggest thing about when you move to the UAE? It is this fantastic melting pot. And I think it's quite surprising when you arrive there, because I think you have an idea of it. And then you actually realize that it's genuinely true that all of these nationalities, cultures are living together and in peace.
In complete harmony.
And I've got friends from all over the world now, and I love that.
Yeah.
And that's what Dubai gave us, and it gave my children too, because they have friends. I mean, they could literally pick somewhere in the world. They've got a friend there. They'd go and stay with them.
That's
amazing.
Yeah. And that's probably what's so amazing about moving overseas, which brings it full circle, funnily enough. I got one question for you. I want to ask you, Lou, and this isn't prepped. If you could move anywhere in the world now, you were given one place and you were allowed, and it was your last global move, where would you go?
One step before you answer that.
Yeah.
What is Louise Rook's answer? Tune in next week to find out.
Come back next week.
Yeah. No, go ahead.
Yeah, I don't. If it wasn't such a long way away, I have always fancied a move to Australia. And I did live in Australia for 1 year when I was 19.
You did, yeah.
But I was a single girl then, and it was a totally different experience.
You should see Anna's face. You did.
I know. I wasn't happy about it. She was gone for a year.
You did.
I was really unhappy because you got to understand, this is my baby sister.
Yeah.
And then she started doing more exciting things than me, firstly. I didn't like that. And
you were just jealous.
A little bit. And secondly...
Oh, I like this beef going on right now.
But she was my baby sister. And also, this leads me on nicely just to say, you know, we're very, very close. You are my best friend in the world.
God bless you guys.
We've been separated by Global Moves, but we've never let it separate us,
nice.
If that makes sense. No. And since the introduction of WhatsApp audios, I think we've become a lot closer again.
Because WhatsApp audio is like therapy, don't you think?
Amazing.
Because you can just pour it all out and the other person has to listen.
That's the complete monopolised audience.
Yeah.
But I'm so proud of you, Lou, and I say that from a big sister point of view.
Whoa.
I'm so proud of you. You've done such amazing things. You know, you've plopped around the world, just randomly picking spots on the globe and moving there. Then you decide that you're going to work in all these places. Then you become managing director of a drama school in Chicago. Then suddenly you start your own podcast. And by the way, you had 750 subscribers before you even launched your first episode. And so I just look at you and go, wow, stop being so productive because I'm older. Thank you.
Wow.
Well, thank you, Anna. But there's mutual admiration here because I always look at you and think, wow, you know, you're on Pulse 95 and you're just doing it all in the UAE and you've got Big Hass
by
your side.
Yeah. One second. Let me stop this. This is incredible. I mean, obviously, you know, God bless both of you. It's amazing to see the love there and the respect there after all these years. You know, you both have incredible kids, families, and you didn't let that, affect you. As we're approaching the end, I just want to say something. I'm sure you know this. I don't know what you call it. Example where there was a dying father on his bed, and he gets his kids in, and he says, bring in sticks, and they bring in sticks alone. And he says, break those sticks, and they break it easily.
Okay.
And he said, go back and bring in a bunch of sticks together, and they find it difficult to break. So family stick together.
Oh,
and it's beautiful to see after all these years you guys are still having that bond, which is amazing because you stick together and life goes back and forth, which is remarkable. But we do have 40 seconds to end. Louise, your social media handle, where can people follow you on Instagram?
I'm on Instagram, Louise Overseas Mover.
That's my name.
Yeah. I'm also on Facebook, and there is a Moving Overseas Facebook page.
Mm-hmm.
There's also a Facebook group as well.
Nice.
Families Moving / Living Overseas. And that's a great resource.
Amazing.
As well.
Wow, you've been busy.
We salute you. The whole thing is going to be up on podcast. Louise, we're just approaching the news. We might keep you for one more link, but if we didn't, much love and much respect.
Thank you so much.
Yes, that's it. You know,
big
that's
love.
All about it. 95. We're going to be right back.
Big House. Driving you home across the Seven Emirates. Lovely having you with us. 7:07. Just waved goodbye to my sister in Chicago, the Windy City in the United States of America. So weird interviewing a family
member. How did that feel?
Do you know what? It was always weird interviewing my dad, to be honest. So through my radio career, depended on what my dad was in. You know, he was an actor. No.
He was there in 1973, ladies and gentlemen. 73, I keep messing up.
I think it is 73.
Star Wars. It is crazy when you interview your family.
Yeah.
But I mean, I saw you guys. You have so much cool energy because obviously you talk via WhatsApp. And like I said at the end, the connection is always there.
Yeah.
You got a couple of kids. She got two kids. And, you know, you have your life here. She has her life in a different time zone.
Yeah.
But yet you find the time. See?
Every day.
And I think that's what I said with the example at the end. When you stick together, nothing can break you.
The
bond. Because I think family is important. We all move around. Like, you know, Hanan is away from her family too.
Yeah.
I think it's for me, in my case, it was very interesting watching all this because from the very, very young age, I was living on my own because I had to really work early to support my dad and my family.
Yeah.
So I've always been, since 17, kind of living on my own.
Right.
So I kind of got used to it.
Right. Like
I kind of got used to the whole thing, not alone. Mom is always away.
Yeah.
I'm always alone.
Right.
Family's always out because I'm working to provide. It's always been like that. So I don't... Watching you talk to your sister right now made me realize it's important, especially if you grew up together and like have like.
Yeah, we were very close. Our mum died when we were young, so that puts an extra bond between us. And we were very close with our mum, so then we just turned in and we looked after each other, and she's my baby sister. But we went into the same industry together.
I know.
We were both actors that ended up in radio. Same story.
Crazy.
We were the only sisters in radio in the UK for a good 5 to 7 years, and so the radio industry loved that. They kept doing articles about us, and I used to lie about my age. I told you this. I used to lie about my age, and Louise didn't lie about her age, and she was obviously the baby sister until we did one big article for a newspaper, and I was younger than her in it, and she went mad. I'd become the little sister. But we've always mirrored each other's careers. We've had shows together. You know, we really have lived. And then when we had children, we were both there at the birth of each of our children.
No way.
For the first 10, 11 years of Charlie's life, her eldest son, you know, they would say, mine too, mummy, both Louise and I would answer. It didn't matter whether they were her kids or my kids.
Yeah. Amazing.
Because we were there from birth. And then when she moved from the UAE, that was a rip. Because even when she moved here, I followed her. It was a rip when she moved to Canada.
Obviously, Louise Rook, she has this podcast. She started this podcast called the Moving Overseas Podcast. Yeah. Edition-wise, I mean, the one she launched right now is Family Edition, and she has, you know, a lot of plans. It's about, you know, what's moving, because it's, you know, and in the podcast, she did an interview with me, and I talk about how difficult it was, how maybe not researched, well-researched we were. We were focusing a lot on the house,
right,
but we didn't do research on the moving itself.
Right.
You know, so we faced a lot of it. Because it's different. Even in Saudi Arabia and the UAE, is way different.
Yeah.
Like, you know, over here, there's a check system. I swear to God, when I came here, I didn't know what a check is.
Wow.
I never had a check in my life.
Okay.
I don't do checks.
Right.
So when
that
I came here,
sense.
Like, what is check? Like, what is a check? I have to sign, like, 4 checks. What are you talking about? What is that?
Yeah.
And I didn't know that, you know? So, again, I didn't know. In Saudi Arabia, we don't deal with checks. It's like, you come in, this is the money. Okay, you want the house? Take it now. Okay, done. She was smiling.
You see, that sounds great. I would love the way it's done in Saudi Arabia.
I know.
The check system, whereas they've started to eradicate them in the UK. So when I got here and suddenly we were all using checks again, I was like, well, hang on, they've made them illegal in the UK.
It's just a different way of doing
different
things.
Systems,
and you have to research the country you're going in. So in our part, we research only the houses where we are, the areas, but we didn't do the actual move.
Okay.
And that's why the podcast is important. And I love what she said about what she has plans for it. Imagine you go to this page, right? And you find out, okay, I want to move to Canada. Right. These are the best places. This is the people to hire, recommended. Wow.
If you've got children. These are the groups if you're not working in your house.
All you got to do is keep pushing that, you know, podcast. Like, keep pushing that podcast so more people would check it out.
I think
it's really remarkable, guys. Again, if you're listening to us right now, it's available on all streaming. The Moving Overseas Podcast Family Edition. You'll be able to hear, you know me, because this was dropped today morning, or actually yesterday, which is incredible. But yeah, she's an incredible soul as well. I really loved meeting her, like, face to, like, camera to camera.
Yeah, did you like seeing her?
Yeah.
The whole family adored you, which is so annoying. Her boys are brilliant. So if Freddie adores you, you know you're in.
Shout out Freddie,
cool,
man,
Freddie.
And Charlie and Lee. I see you guys.
If you liked this episode of Yalla Home, drop a like and subscribe. 95. Be sure to follow us on Instagram for all our daily updates and top stories.